song or testimony or something on your heart that you may want to give this time, you may do so at this time.
Everybody,
you don't take a whole night. Even if you just wave your hand.
Do it. say, why you tell me? God, we thank you because there's a sweet spirit in here, God. And I know it's the presence of the Lord. God, we say thank you, God, for what you're going to do in this worship on today, Lord God. God, we thank you, God, that your kingdom citizens has assembled in this embassy, God, to give you praise, God, to hear a word from you, oh God. God, we thank you, God, for the messenger, Lord God, that's heard straight from the throne room of God. Lord, we say thank you, God. God, our hearts are in a position to receive, God. God, that we can cause earth to look like heaven, God. That we may establish a culture in the earth, Lord God. That when the world see us, God, they'll see you working in and through us, God. They'll see the kingdom of God manifested in us, God. Lord, we say thank you, Father. And for every distracted spirit, we bind you right now in the name of Jesus. We take authority over you. And say we render you powerless in this place on today. That the citizens of God will hear that's what said the Lord. In this place, God. God, we thank you, God, for the messenger. We ask you, God, that you will continue to use him and bless him, Father. God, we say thank you, God. And for the choir, God, that we render songs to you, Lord God. That we may be a brief way we receive our message through the song, God. God, that we can run, tell women, men, boys, and girls that the kingdom of God is here, now, in the earth. God, we say thank you. We bless you, Lord God. Bless every heart, every hero in this embassy, God. That your praises shall continually go forth in our mouth, God. Out of our mouth, God. That we'll give you glory and that we'll give you praise. We thank you, God, for the anointing that would fill this place, God. That signs, wonders, and miracles will stop to follow those that believe, God. And Lord, we say thank you, God. And when we leave this embassy, Lord God, God, we will run and we will tell, God, the miracle, the wondrous things, God, that you are yet and still doing in the earth, Lord God, and in your kingdom, God. And Lord, our heart rejoices. We say thank you, Abba Father. Abba Father, we say thank you. And we give you glory in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen.
Yeah.
We are heading to the meat for the dessert.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. We are ready for the word. Hallelujah. Yeah. If I have any fellow citizens of the kingdom of God in the house today, stand on your feet and give God a praise for the word.
Thank you. Give me you. Just give me you, Lord. Just give me you. Everything else must wait. Give me you. Hallelujah. If you find yourself at the end of your road, you in the right time and the right place for God to give him all of him. You know, sometimes we tell the Lord, give me all of you, but when he starts pouring himself on us, then we start drawing back. But I heard a song that say, oh, taste.
Yeah.
And see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusts in him. Hallelujah. Jesus said it like this in the attitude to be in Matthew 5. He said, blessed are they that hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. How do you see yourself? Half full or half empty? In the course of how you see yourself. Hallelujah. God, give me you. And we'll put everything else on hold. That was a message right there. And he told you, you're not too late. I will look to the healing. From which coming? My help. My help coming from the Lord that made heaven and earth. How many know that if it had not been for the Lord on your side? Tell your neighbor, say he was on your side too. The reason why you are here today is because the Lord was on all of our side. And when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for you and me, my soul. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Your bank account didn't get you this far. I know some of y'all think that sometimes. Your houses didn't get you this far. Your cars didn't get you this far. Your clothes didn't get you this far. Your friends didn't get you this far. If it had not been for the Lord who was on my side. Hallelujah. Yeah. We give too much credit to everything else but the Lord. Amen. We can shout for a new job. We can shout for a new house. But when the scriptures say, let everything that had breath praise ye the Lord, you sit down. That it means you too. Hallelujah. We are here to celebrate the goodness of the Lord. We are here to admonish and adore and admire our King and our Lord. Amen, somebody. Because God has been so, so good. Some of the saints of old say he's been better to me. I've been to myself, and that's a true statement. Yeah. Hallelujah. Thank God that he is better to us than we have been to ourselves. Hallelujah. Yeah. All right, let's go ahead and get in the word. Let's get in the word while I get raptured. I get raptured. Amen. We do give honor to our Lord and our Savior, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Creator of heaven and earth, the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. the Almighty. I say we give.
Hallelujah.
Because he is worthy of all of our praise and worship. We thank God for our worship leader today. He is in the very presence of the awesome God that we serve, none other than Pastor Wallette Fauntleroy. Amen. Amen. Good to have our present day Moses, the assistant pastor, back with us today. And I have been Pastor Jacob Plummer. Amen. Amen. Thank God for one of my mentors, a son of this embassy, none other than the esteemed pastor of the Bible Hope Baptist Church right down in Northumberland County. Pastor Frank Brooks. Amen. Hallelujah. Always good to have him in fellowship with us. We thank God for one of my neighborhood friends, and now we are in the Lord and in the kingdom together. Amen. None other than Patrick Wilson, Minister Patrick Wilson. Amen. Amen. We know, amen, that God has graced us with an awesome youth pastor, as well as operating the calling of a prophetess. Amen. None other than prophetess, youth pastor Vicki Brown. Amen. Amen. Thank God for Pastor James Thornton and First Lady Thornton with us today. And thank God for all of, I tell you what, I just want all of the clergy to stand up, but I don't want to miss no one. Thank God for Prophet Sherry Blackman that laid us. Amen. Amen. Thank God for Reverend Sheila, Reverend Teresa. Amen. May the shout coming at this. Amen. Bless the Lord. Amen. Thank God for all of the ushers. Thank God for my favor and my glory. And all of the first ladies. Thank God for the holiest gift that God has graced us with, Danica Smith, one of our. Amen. Thank God for all of you. Amen. We're not going to call you a visitor. But whenever you're in the house of the Lord,
amen.
You are not a visitor. You are in the right place. Amen. Amen. Good to see Brother Coleman, Brother Ralph. Amen. Raise your hand, Brother Ralph. Amen. God bless you, sir. Good to have you. Let's give the Lord another hand clap of praise for the man cross. For the election of Brother Antonio and all the glory of Brother Larry Coleman. Amen. Amen. Let's get into the word. Let's get into the word. Give the Lord about 15 minutes of the time that he's given you in time that he can speak to you to help you to deal with life. How many people are still allowing life to be an experience? How many of us in here are still allowing life to be an experience? Okay, some of y'all missed that. Some of y'all scared, think that's a trick question. That's not a trick question. Now, you don't want to allow life to become an experiment. Life to become an experiment. That means you do this for a while, and when it don't work, you try something else and do that for another little while. Need that to validate in your thinking, because some of y'all are set right in that place. You're still experimenting with life. and you're not experiencing the fullness of what God sent you in the earth to do because you don't understand, can you? And you still allow people to dupe you, and you're satisfied with where you are because you got a ticket to go to heaven, and that's sufficient for you. But God wants more than you to go to be with him in heaven. He wants you to experience heaven on earth before you get to be back with him. So for some of us, life has become an experiment. Because we don't understand the power of priority. When you understand the power of priority, then what takes place is you can eliminate a lot of things that you use the most, two most important commodities God has given us, the time and energy. And when you understand the power of priority, you can then eliminate yourself from wasting the one of the two most important commodities, which is time. You will stop wasting your time being busy but not effective. Because we've mastered that. Some of y'all happy with just having church. I just lost a few of y'all right there. Amen. So we're going to talk about kingdom laws for kingdom living. Last week we initiated the value of law, of kingdom law. The value of kingdom law. I need you to reach to your neighbor and grab their hand. Somebody sit beside you, hold their hand. Don't you know that no one else's hand that you hold have their same fingerprints?
Come on.
Trying to help you, y'all, to see something. You are touching an original. Okay, y'all. You are touching an original. And if they really knew how valuable you really are, they would take you out for lunch tomorrow.
Yeah.
talking to you, he's talking to the person behind him. Yeah. God is trying to get the maximum out of us. And we settle for these religious stuff that keeping us in the minimum.
Come on, hey.
Okay, let me shift right on. Yeah, here we is. Here we are. Here we are. Last week we were talking about a 600,000-pound apple. To show you how powerful the law of lift is over the law of gravity. We're talking about law now. Let me give you a definition of law so you'll understand. I'll give you a definition of law first. Law is, for some of y'all that like to take notes, law is a principle based on a predictable circumstance of an act. Law is a principle based on a predictable circumstance of an act. Predicted end result. Predicted end result. That means every time you embark on doing a certain law, you should get the end of you beginning that law. That means every time you do it, you should get the same result.
Yeah.
Come on. Come on. That means it never changed.
Yeah.
So for some of us to say that we've been submitting to the law of God and you get a different result than what God said, evidently you better go back and check it because God can't be a liar.
Come on.
Okay, since y'all ain't buying it, Romans 3 and 4 say, let every man be a liar, let God be. I say, let every man be a liar and let God be. So once that plane get on the tarmac and get on the runway, now the And once that law of lift kicks in and you start flying, you got to make sure you still maintain that same speed. Oh, have mercy.
Y'all listen now to hear.
And Peter got a tweet and a text from heaven. Maybe I thought some of y'all can relate to this. And Jesus said, flesh and blood didn't reveal this to you, Simon Bar-Jonah, but my Father in heaven. Amen. He said, stop trying to make Jesus John the Baptist, Isaiah, Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. A prophet don't have a kingdom. Okay, I know I'm losing hope here now. I say a prophet don't have a kingdom. A prophet speak the oracles of what God say to speak and prophesy. So a prophet don't have a kingdom, so he couldn't have been a prophet. Didn't mean that he operated as a prophet. He was a king and he's Lord. We reduced him to be a prophet. So he said, after you listen to what man say, did not heaven to tell you who he really is. Because Jesus said, when you seen me, you seen the Father. And I didn't come just to give you a prophecy. I came to reestablish my kingdom that the first mankind had a law. Because you can only bring what somebody lost. And he didn't lose a religion because he didn't give Adam a religion. Lose the cross because he didn't give Adam a cross. He lost a kingdom in that word dominion. Adam lost kingdom. That's what he lost. And Jesus said, once you are tired of listening to what man say, then heaven will tell you who I am. And then Jesus said something. Y'all have the scripture? Y'all didn't even hear what the Lord said though. Chapter 16, verse number 19. Someone stand up and read. I like the congregation participation. Somebody stand up and read. Read verse.
And I will give them to the kingdom.
Stop right there. He said, he'll give you what?
Peace.
He said, he'll give you what?
Peace.
He said, he'll give you what?
Keys.
Keys to what? Keys.
Kingdom of heaven.
Of the kingdom of heaven.
Yes.
He said, I'm going to teach you the laws. Yeah. I'm going to teach you the laws. Because when somebody gives you something of it, they got to first give it to you before you embrace it.
Yeah.
And see, listen to this. You are not born with a culture. Because culture and laws go together.
Yeah.
Culture is never in a territory or a place. Is lived out in a territory and a place.
Yes.
But culture is always in people.
Yeah.
And you learn your culture through the growth medium of the family and the area you've grown up in.
Yes.
That's why the scriptures say, while they're young, you should train them up in the way that they should go, and when they get older, they should not depart from it. Don't wait until they get adults and try to get something in them. Because they're learning different cultures.
Yes.
Lord, help me, Jesus. Is the laws that have been established. Some of y'all think our constitution is the right constitution. I want to say something, but certain times the Holy Ghost allows you to look around, you can't say something. People really don't understand. Whenever you get a constitution, I don't care where in the earth, when it starts out with we the people, it's wrong. The Lord just for finished.
Yes.
I say whenever you get a constitution, which is a legal document, whenever you get a constitution that says we the people, that means the people governs.
Yes. That's right.
And whoever is in cahoots together with we the people, you might be eliminated. See, by us, growing up in a Western culture, the only thing we know of a kingdom is when we were, once some of y'all historians, when we were connected to the British.
Yes.
England. But then we declared independence.
Yes, yes, yes.
Because we wanted to be a free.
Right.
Come on now.
Come on.
And now we establish our own constitution, not with our saying, but our, the Lord say, we the people, and then we put the Lord's name behind it.
Come on.
But Jesus said, in Matthew 6, I believe it is, he said, you have heard. When you start understanding the kingdom, listen to this. When a king speaks, his word automatically becomes law.
Yes.
Can I give you an example? Can I give you an example?
Yes, yes.
John the Baptist being the forerunner to be the introduced Jesus.
Yes.
When Herod messed around and married a woman that he ain't had no business marrying, that was his brother. John the Baptist told him he ain't had no business doing it. So the woman that Herod, and Herod liked John the Baptist. I'm trying to show y'all something, but when a king speaks, it automatically becomes law. So now, back then, they had something called dance. They would dance for the king, and if they were pleased and make the king happy, whatever the king said, he could give them his whole kingdom if he wanted to. See, and that young lady, or that woman that was married to Herod, she went and told her daughter, and watch people that manipulate their in power.
Yes.
Because they'll use somebody else to do something to you that they really want to do, and you're foolish enough to do it because you ain't spiritually discerned to tell them you do your own dirt. Okay. So this young lady, Wayne, she started dancing. And it pleased her. And Herod had told her by her mother. Her mother told her, say, when you go to Herod, ask for John the Baptist. He. Y'all ain't see that in scripture, because y'all already looking at religiously. Because we don't understand kings. So King Herod say, well, I'll give you whatever you ask of me if you please me. So the young lady danced and pleased King Herod. And when it was time for her to get what he told her, because when he speaks, he can't take it back.
Right.
He gotta do what he told her.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because when a king speaks, their integrity is always in his word.
Yeah.
That means if he tells you something, that means he gonna do it.
Right.
So the young lady danced and pleased King Herod. And now, they go John the Baptist down in the dungeon. And she said, King Herod, give me John the Baptist here.
Yes.
And King Herod, what have I done?
Yes.
And guess what happened? John got beheaded.
Yes.
Lord have mercy. Some of y'all got quiet. What y'all get quiet for? See, whenever a king speaks, his word automatically becomes law. Why is it that we don't put no emphasis on the word of God? As we should have been. Because when the king speaks, it automatically becomes law. And if you live by the law of the word, what Psalm 1 say? Blessed It's called faith. Y'all didn't catch it. I said y'all didn't catch it. See, if a bummer mess around and give somebody 50 acres of something that he's the president over a country and he don't own it, it's called corruption.
Yes.
Even if he does own it, it's still called corruption in politics.
Yes.
But if the Lord can give you 50 acres, it's called faith. That means that he don't have to ask nobody permission to bless you. Why? Because Psalm 24 says, the earth is the Lord. Yeah. It's the way we think. I said the way we think. And in democracy, we have been influenced by we the people.
Yes.
And let me help some of y'all. That you always got to go pray to help somebody.
Amen.
Let me help somebody. You do not need to go pray if you got the Lord's goods and a person is in need.
Yes.
You do not need to call a special meeting to get 15 people to vote on putting oil in an elderly person's tank that they don't have enough fuel to stay home during the winter months. This time the church votes on something else. I hope the Lord sends half a man and consume the whole church. Say, I hope he come and consume the whole church. You will vote on. And you got the Lord's money. Y'all want scripture for that? That's why the children of Israel wandered around in the wilderness for 40 years, because 10 of them voted. Oh, y'all catch that language. If God told you to go possess something, you don't need to vote. You need to go possess it. If God already told you you're the head, not the tail, you need to be the head. If God told you you're the lender, not the borrower, you need to be the lender. God told you you're above and not beneath, you need to be above. That's a long word. But everything, we always got to vote on it. See, in the kingdom, ain't no vote.
Right.
I say it, the Lord. And if the Lord say, I say, that's all that needs to be said. Because some of y'all that really can hear the Lord is going to start telling you to do some things. And it's really not the devil. The devil is never going to tell you to do anything good. So I'm going to help you discern the voice of the Lord to make sure it's not the devil. Lord have mercy. Amen. Amen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
If you don't know something about something, you should go learn about it before you talk against it. Because you might be talking against the very thing that God's going to get you where he's trying to get you.
Yeah.
Last thing, because sometimes God will send you what you need in a package, wrapped up in a package you don't want. Y'all didn't get that. I say sometimes God will send you, Brother Mike, what you need wrapped in a package you don't want.
Yes.
Doesn't mean what you need is not wrapped up in the package, but you don't have what it's wrapped up in.
Yes.
And God is sending you what you need in the one thing that has everything you need, but you don't like the package that it's wrapped up in.
Come on.
And now you calling it the devil. Amen, somebody. But Jesus said, once you understand the laws, the keys of the kingdom, which are laws, he said the very gates of hell, that's what he said, will not prevail against you. He didn't say because you're not somebody, God be for you.
God be for you.
Who can be against you?
Who can be against you?
Say it to your face. Amen. Get ready to go down and break some bread now. What's that crazy stuff that preacher up there preaching y'all that, teaching y'all that? I'm just teaching what Jesus taught. The kingdom of heaven and the kingdom of God. What is the kingdom? See, this is a collaboration. It's a collaboration of scriptures. The kingdom is the sovereign rulership, the governing influence of a king over his territory. Impacting it and influencing it with his own personal will, intent, and purpose. He creates a citizenry, which is a people, that has a culture that will reflect the lifestyle of the king. And the sad indictment on most churches is that we go to church, but we don't reflect the king. Because you don't live like them. We don't act like them. Come on, help me somebody. Our values is not his values. Come on. Amen, somebody. But the Lord is just looking for a few citizens that will come under the culture of heaven to cause earth to look like. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. See, some of y'all still trying to get two wings to fly away, and Jesus is trying to get the influence of heaven through you in the earth. See, you don't have to go to heaven to experience heaven. All you got to do is find someone that has the Holy Spirit, and he teaches us a culture of the invisible, unseen, celestial realm that you haven't been to, that you're waiting to go to. Because I told you, culture is always in a person or people. You don't need to go to China to experience China. All you gotta do is find some people in a certain place in America that have that culture, and you can get a little bit of China right there. Trying to help somebody. Hey, teach us how to pray, Jesus, as John taught his disciples. Jesus said, this is how you pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, not religion. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So you don't need to go to heaven to know how heaven is. You just had to come in contact with enough people that's filled with the Spirit of God. What is the easiest way to become a citizen of a country? What Jesus told Nicodemus. Nicodemus, y'all missed that in John 3. He told Nicodemus he did not preach being born again. He just shared in one time and moment at night with Nicodemus. He said, you must be born of the Spirit and the water if you will see your answer. And we made messages out of born again. Jesus never preached born again. He just shared born again with Nicodemus. Yeah. So the simplest way to become a part of a country is to be born in it. That's how you get your citizenship. And see, Paul had some revelation that we had gleaned from, and we still miss kingdom. Paul said, I have dual citizenship. Paul said, my citizenship is in heaven, and my citizenship is being a part of the Rome. Rome, I'm a citizen of Rome. So when they say it, when you're in Rome, do as the Romans do. So when you see, you gotta go and stay. Roman soldiers, without the emperor's permission, could not hit another Roman citizen. membership. Because membership only gives you rights and privileges and benefits when you stay in line with temporary authority. Law membership. Law membership. But when you get your eternal citizenship, no matter if this earthly temporary authority don't want you to be blessed, they can't stop you from being blessed. Some of y'all been hanging out with the wrong folk. I say some of y'all been hanging out. I did not solicit you to join. I would never solicit any person to join this embassy at Mount Jerusalem. Because I don't know what you're bringing. If the Lord sent you, I know and hope they put attention. Because one or two people, Lord have mercy. One or two people can come and pop church up. But see, you can't tell this kind of kingdom up because it's not established by man. Pastor Lorenzo, that's why you got to be careful who you let come in. Because the very one that will tell you all these great things, they're a very manipulative person. So if they feel that they get connected to the pastor, let me get connected to our old Lorenzo Tate. I get connected to him, I can push my own agenda. But let me help some of y'all. That's a spiritual man. Hallelujah. And when you're spiritual, you try to spirit by the spirit to make sure it's of God. So you don't have to solicit for anybody, huh? All you got to do is do what the Lord said, and the Lord will send. I said the Lord will send. And when the Lord said, and when the Lord said, thank God for you, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. When the Lord said them, you don't have to worry about it. I say when the Lord said them. Hallelujah. The simplest way to be born in a country, to get citizenship in the country to be born. With head bowed and eyes closed. Romans 10 and 9 says, thou wilt confess with the mouth of the Lord Jesus, believe in heart, God, praise from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Did anyone in here that don't know Jesus as your Savior? You have never made him the Lord of your life. See, when you make him not only Savior, but the Lord of your life, that means that he takes total responsibility for your life. And then you got to submit to what his word says, so that he can be the landlord of your life. And when anything is broken, he's responsible for fixing it according to your faith and what his word say as a citizen of his kingdom. Are you here today? God bless you. Everyone saved? Everyone ready to go to be with the Lord? Listen, as I share this with you, are you ready to give out instruction? Because we have another worship experience at 3 o'clock. We want to get you fed. Amen. But don't get so full that you don't come back. Amen. Hallelujah. Listen, God is waiting for you to say yes to him. And when you say yes to him, he'll transform your life. Because he said, Jeremiah said, I know the plans that I have for you, said the Lord. Plans of good and not of evil. Plans to give you a future and expect an end. God already knows the plan that he has for your life. But you need to surrender your life to him. God bless you. If anyone need prayer for agreement, I agree with you. I agree with you. If you need prayer, something, I agree with you. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I agree with you. I agree with you, I agree with you, I agree with you. But listen, the Lord will hear you just as quick as he'll hear me. Father, I stretch and I release my faith with them now. Whatever they stand in need of, according to your will, which is your word. Father, we take authority over the wicked one and evil one. We deem him to be powerless over us. For we do walk by faith and not by sight. We are the just, we've been justified. We have peace with you through the blood. So I bring these out of your citizen up before the court of heaven. And I plead their rights, their benefits, and their privileges. The blood of Jesus has erased everything that might would hinder them from coming before your court. So, Father, this is the confidence that we have in you, that if we ask anything according to your will, and know you hear us, we have the petition we have asked of thee. Your word said, beloved, above all things, I wish that you prosper, be in health, even as thy soul prosper. Now, God, we ask you now in Jesus' name to intervene and interfere in earthly affairs through us giving you the legal right through this prayer. Because you say, we're two on earth, that's the grief. Hallelujah. Heaven will back up earth. So God, we in agreement. We confess what you say. In Jesus' name. It is so. We charge the angelic host of heaven to bring a speedy answer. Because God, you are still perfecting those things that concern us. In Jesus' name, we ask it on your thanks, our souls say. Amen. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. We gotta move fast. Listen, if you want a copy of the worship experience, see Brother Miller. He can get you a CD if you want to listen to it while you're going to work or wherever, while you're driving. If you want a DVD, he can get that for you too. Amen. So see Brother Miller. He can fill you in on. All right. Okay, here we go, saints. Here we go. We have the black back classroom set up. We have the back classroom set up for the seasoned saints. For the seasoned saints. I want someone to come up front that will guide and direct them back there. We don't want you to go downstairs. If you want to go downstairs, you can go downstairs, but we want to save you some steps. I want someone to come up and direct the seasoned saints in the back. Amen. So you don't have to just follow Brother Wilson. Follow Brother Wilson once I give the benediction. And everyone else can assemble downstairs now. New Jerusalem, y'all just about know what Pastor gonna say. I wanna see you in front of none of the rest of the citizens that are not from New Jerusalem. Okay? So let our sisters and brothers dine for sufficient the first, and then you can follow suit. Amen? Amen. Amen. I ain't hear enough of the citizens from New Jerusalem say amen. If you choose to get something in a carryout tray and go up underneath the pavilion, help yourself. Amen. Amen. Help yourself. You don't have to stay bottled up downstairs. Okay? So once I give the benediction and the blessing of the food, amen, we get ready to go downstairs and dine sufficiently. Eat all you want, but don't eat too much that you overstuff yourself. Amen. All right. Did we miss anything? Amen. Good to have everybody. Let me speak to. God bless you. Thank God for you coming. I'm going to ask Pastor Brooks to give us the benediction and the blessing of the food. Amen.
May we all pray. Father God, we thank you for my eyes and seeing the ears and the ears. We ask you a special blessing and Father God of unto. We ask you to bless the one who brought it, bless the one who approached it, and bless the one who came here. Now may the grace of God, through the communion of the Holy Spirit, bless you and divide these ones, that we all meet again. Amen.
Amen. Amen.